What are you looking at, man?
Spintronix is that crew in the Bay Area that taught all the crews how to be the crew. You know, we were always like in awe, every little step.
Going back to the root of it all was the music. And you know, it was like most cutting edge music at the time and the flawless mixing.
I'd see their setups and I'm like, damn, that's how they did that. Oh, that's dope. You know, like, you know, it was inspiring. It was always a different setup, you know, I'm sure like, there was different like diagrams that the crew would make out for their next setup. It was always stepping it up to a different kind of visual aspect. And you know, the mixing, of course, you got the legends, Chris Miguel, you got Dino, you know what I mean? Like,
about an issue with DJ Times, I read an article, I saw a Daly City crew. I said, man, dudes from Daly City could be in a magazine. Man, I want to be part of this. And that was in sixth grade.
It's definitely the brotherhood that Spintronix forms. It's all the folks, past and present, creative talents, skill sets, knowledge, hard work. That's all of the above made Spintronix what it is.
You know, when we started doing this, we do full-on gigs, full-on trussing, full-on setups. And then at the end of the day, you get enough money to buy pizza.
Sometimes the gigs weren't even the fun part. It was meeting at Chris's house at 3 in the afternoon to load the truck, and Mr. Miguel would be there, and he would be talking a bunch of mess to everybody.
It started off with myself and Dino Rivera and several friends. We put together our own mobile DJ group.
We had this tiny little group called Modern Motion. But we were focusing more on New Wave, where everyone else was focusing on hip hop and R&B.
Started off with my friend, this guy named Jay Lorenzano, who lives in Chicago now.
Westmore had a dance. I forget who sponsored the dance, but it was like a little DJ showcase. So Carmen took me with him. And I saw Chris in action with his partner at the time. There was only two or three of them in the group. And I was really impressed with Chris's skills. And then Corman said, hey, I have this great idea. You're our DJ from this group, Chris is there. We'll put the two together and we'll see what we can do.
And he approached us. He said, I heard you guys are DJing. Can you bring me a demo tape? And then I gave him a demo and he was listening to it. Then he kind of realized, you know, maybe we can join forces and, you know, do better things if we combine as a group.
I just said, hey, why don't we just, you know, let us join Spintronix. We'll get together with you and I have this awesome DJ that's with me and it just started like that. And Chris was like, cool. And it just so happened that there was a dance coming up at Westmore that we were able to all kind of work together on and started off from there.
At that time, you know, Chris Miguel and Dino Rivera, a lot of their mixtapes made its rounds all over Northern California. In my opinion, I think their four turntable mixers were among the best of that era.
I patterned my style after Cameron Paul. So Cameron has this way of telling stories with words, with lyrics. And that was what I liked to do. And Chris was like speed mixing, you know, like every 16 beats, boom, 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 boom. That was his style.
He just was able to come up with songs that would work. And then like when I would come up with a part, he would go, hey, this sounds pretty good with it, listen to this. Or we bring a song over, I like, got him a song that'll work with it. So we would like lock ourselves up down and practice until, you know, we come up with a set that sounded cool.
first, it just started out for fun and passion, and you know, like everyone else in the Bay Area, especially Daly City, the goal was just get a group, be DJs, get your name out there, get recognition. It wasn't even about money at the time. But then a few gigs, you know, one gig after another every weekend, and we started realizing, hey, there's some money to be made in this, right? And so we started thinking, all right, we should take this seriously and make it a business.
You know, for those who are not from the Bay Area and who are trying to understand how is it that all these sort of world-class DJs came out of the Bay Area, I think a lot of it had to do with the fact that even though the Bay is sort of this, you know, it's a big metropolis geographically and population-wise, it's still actually kind of small compared to LA or New York. And that what you had in the Bay Area, especially in the 80s and by the 90s, is you have a relatively small community. Everyone knows each other, and everyone's really competitive with one another.
To stand out, one of the marks that you've made it, so to speak, was when you were a part of an Imagine Showcase, or a AA Production Showcase, or a Just for Fun show.
AA, we hit up the East Bay. And then you have Just for Fun, which, you know, hit up the Vallejo area and Fairfield area. I mean, imagine just teenagers just getting out all over the Bay Area.
It would be like four sound systems set up in one room, and everyone would get their like their little 15 minutes to 40 minutes set up, like, you know, all right, come over, you know, once they were done, and all right, y'all, come over to this side. Spintronix is about to start, we're about to start it up. And, you know, they start their whole live show and their whole mix. It's like a presentation.
They came in as a crew, they looked like a crew, you know, they were always professional as a crew, you know, and their reputation as a crew all together was always like, always top notch. It was the standard that everybody followed. And of course, you couldn't always go to these shows, so it reflected on the mixtape, because that's what these guys would do live.
You know, people are just looking at you, you're not really, you know, they're not really dancing, they're just watching you mix. It's kind of awkward. You know, that's why we practice hard, so that we don't have to mess up and, you know, not make ourselves look bad.
Well, for the old school, Imagine was a defining moment for the crew. Because our generation, that was the showcase, the battle to, you know, get involved with.
In the late 80s and early 90s, a lot of the mobile crews at the time formed alliances. You know, there was the Legion of Boom, and before that, there was the Juice Crew with Unique Music and Unlimited Sound. So it was just a natural progression for Spintronix to team with another mobile crew. We didn't have quite an alliance name, but we did a lot of gigs with Lifestyle Productions.
Awesome DJs like, you know, Darwin, Mark, Armando, and everybody knows Q-Bert came out of Lifestyle, so you can't deny that they produced some really talented folks as well.
With the beat, it was like another jump up in the ladder for us. They brought a lot of technical skill as far as equipment and gear and coming up with setups that were just different than other groups. We had the DJing skill, and they had the setup skills. Those times when we would do those gigs, pretty memorable because it kind of helped us get faster and get more popular and with the party scene and the club scene because we were known for the setups after that union.
Good Lord, I've never seen people bring in air compressors? Air compressors to set up a trussing and three triangles. I mean, and I, you know, these are things that they prep for at Westlake Gym.
We all lived in Daly City, and it just made sense for us to come together and form an alliance group, which we called The Power.
I think it was just a bunch of guys just love doing what they do and wanted to impress, just, you know, show the the people that like partying, you know, how it can be done. When me and Dino used to make mixes, we felt that was a way that we got pretty popular with the turntables, because they spread like wildfire. When people got them, they always had four turntables to listen to it. It's kind of cool, it's kind of different. So then when I kind of like started to slow down in DJing, Chris Rebel came up, and you know, we noticed that he had a cool funky style. So he came up with this mix.
Yo man, I don't think they heard you. Why don't you tell them what your name is?
The Rebel. I'll tell you a story. I remember getting Rebel's 91 Keeping the Faith tape and wanting to quit. I heard that tape and I was like, there's no way I could ever be this good.
When I started working on the Keeping the Faith mix, it was, you know, me coming in the group, and I kind of really wanted to make an impact, both for myself, the group, in the DJ community.
Together we witnessed one of the most delightful in our time, so let the faith go.
I just decided to hunker down in my, you know, bedroom / studio and just go through all my records, think of all the craziest concepts I could do and just put them together. You know, after hearing all the classic mixes from Chris and Dino, I was just like, you know, I just need to at least come out with something that everybody's gonna like and say, okay, cool. He's living up to the standards of what they set down.
I think everyone gets a kick when he comes around. It gets everybody loose. And so everyone's like having a good time. And I think he enjoys the company. Everyone enjoys his company.
Lou Miguel, he was and is the foundation of Spintronix. There would be no Spintronix without Lou Miguel.
Mr. Miguel was involved with Chris's hobby. This was Chris's thing. This was Chris's crew. But yet Mr. Miguel was part of the crew. He wasn't like Chris's dad. He was like there with us. You know, he drove us around. He would hang out with us. I mean, this is, you know, our friend's dad, and we don't normally see our friend's dad with us.
He was always a father to everybody. I saw how he took care of Chris, and as a father myself now, I understand it, and I hope that I have my relationship like that with my son when he's older.
Even to guys who have never met Lou Miguel, what he instilled in us, we are passing on to them.
And give them the support to them, not to go to drugs or, you know, entangle themselves into fights or problems.
Mr. Miguel was everything to that company. He was the heart and soul of that company, really. I mean, I don't think without his support, the group would have lasted. Everybody would have probably splintered, but I think it was the fact that he, just the small stuff, like allowing all the stuff to be there. Like, that couldn't have been easy for his parents to have, you know, 15 dudes come to the house every Friday and Saturday and hang out and make all sorts of noise all night, loading equipment and putting stuff in and out of the house. And just, that couldn't have been easy, but they loved their son. And he loved his son, and he loved everybody. And Mr. Miguel was a good guy. He really was. And he is missed by everybody.
Lou Miguel is the heart and soul of Spintronix. Really is. I think about him all the time, and you know, I miss him dearly. Really do.
You know, it's like he will surely be missed, and I think the reason why is because he was well loved.
Growing up, you've always think of, you know, there's always people that you say, hey, once this person passes, it'll affect you in one way, right?
You know, he's with me no matter what, and I think that he drives me forward. You know, I kind of like sense him all around me, so I know that I'll see him again.
We'll be right back.
When we first formed the Spintronix, we had about maybe 20 members strong. You know, I'd say half the guys knew how to DJ, but little by little, as 2 or 3 years passed, we'd lose guys left and right, you know. So there was a time, probably 5 or 6 years after we formed Spintronix, where I got to a point where I got burned out. So I just kind of stopped DJing altogether.
So, you know, we have guys that came in and left because they were going back to school, working full time at another company, doing what they, you know, studied for.
I really feel like the change from Spintronix to different ventures wasn't so much, you know, it had to be done, but it was just a natural progression.
I think when the change happened for me as far as the role in the group, it was just because other guys in the group started to come up, and I wanted to give them opportunities to DJ and stuff, to be the top guy as far as being the head DJ when they're doing events. For me, it's like I've done my time as far as a DJ. I mean, I still know how to mix, I still love the music, I still collect songs and stuff, and I like listening to music.
Well, actually, I look at Spintronix as a catalyst for a lot of positive changes. In 98, I was an intern DJ mixing at Wild 94.9 for free at night. I had was doing a few minor clubs here and there. Now I'm pretty much do any club I want to do. I've traveled the country DJing. I've done it all with DJing. I love it still. I don't ever want to stop. You know, Spintronix has always been a backbone to me.
I wouldn't call it moving on. I would just call it adding on.
Me and some other members, you know, we were very proactive and befriended a lot of these mobile crews and targeted some of their members and to offer them bigger opportunities.
At this point, Spintronix has a name, right? So if someone comes up to you and says, hey, would you want to be part of Spintronix? What, are you gonna think about it?
It just kind of was strange how they all came together. I can't explain how that all happened. It just happened naturally. I think that was the magical thing about it. But it was cool because everyone had their own talents.
Every generation seems to spew all of this awesome talent, right? I mean, if you look at all the generations of Spintronix, it's really produced some awesome folks. Not only in the DJ scene, okay? I mean, I'm talking about guys that are talented in the technical field. You know, there was a time when I saw the Lapid brothers putting together awesome cases rigged up for straight power and amp distribution and speaker distribution. I mean, they just found a way to make setup and breakdown so efficient.
Never do business with friends, but you can't help it with this because you start off as friends, right? And I think as you getting serious, especially we became making money, you know, looking at the financials and all that stuff. I think what always is in play is the creative differences, right? There's some people that wants to lead it this way, there's some people that wants to lead it this way, right? And those will always happen.
We've always adopted this family type model, and we've integrated that to our business. And in every family, in every business, there's gonna be, you know, its peaks and valleys. And I think if you look at it as a brotherhood first and a business second, I think you can overcome any kind of obstacles.
They're gonna be the next group of guys to kind of harness the next wave, shall we say. And this wave has access to social networking, access to, you know, video mixing, access to miniature setups that put out maximum sound and visuals. So it's this entire experience that we were talking about. Like, the old school tried to bring that experience of like a little club scene and do this and that. But these guys, they're putting on a show. And these guys know all about that stuff. And they have to teach the next generation. So the next 25 years is just gonna be freaking crazy technology being applied to DJ.
We try to be the first of technology to
push out there for our clientele.
The longevity of Spintronix comes through innovation, where it comes from creative mixing, which is the forefront and basis of any good mobile company, great music, our setups are incredible. Even now, when we don't do the big giant setups, the very small details of uplighting, you don't see mobile companies do uplighting. Innovation, that's what makes us the best.
The move for Spintronix to jump into the whole corporate LLC structure was more of a way to give it certain rules and give it certain responsibilities. And it's a responsibility not only to our clients, but also a responsibility for our brothers that are going out there getting the gigs. You've got your Eric Yees, you know, you've got your L Dogs now doing the gigs, and you've got Charles and all these guys getting out there. We wanna let them know that, hey, you're in Spintronix, but this is how it's structured.
I know that this company will be in business. It will innovate and it will create new levels and new paths for younger kids. Who knows, one of the next great DJs of the world could come out of the ranks of Spintronix. We've got a few kids who've got some real talent. You know, we could branch off into straight production. We can go full on video. There's so much we can do, so much talent in this company itself that we're unstoppable.
That drive and that passion is something that I hope they get a chance to feel that. The drive to go after a vision.
To me, I mean, what stands out about Spintronix is that they're as vibrant today as they probably were when they started. And again, you can't say that about almost any other crew.
They are the greatest mobile DJ group in the Bay. I would have to say that right now.
When you say that name too, you say Spintronix, everybody knows. It doesn't matter what generation you're from. You know there's a little history of you that trusts that name and be like, oh yeah, you know, DJs, the Bay.
I can just see the dreams we had back in 85 being the same dreams that the future generations will have 25 years from now. That stuff never changes. Technology, music change, but the dreams and the drive doesn't change. It's all the same.
I mean, the main difference is just the time, the era. It's not even, I mean, we all share the same interests. We all DJs, we all like music. I mean, we may play it differently, we may have our different styles, but it's all the same. We all call music our number one priority.
It's profitable now, but back then it wasn't when we were starting. And you know, so I only have those who aren't in the group anymore to thank for the time that they've put into the group.
We're always gonna come home. And no matter what we do, it always reflects back to Spintronix and how it can benefit the group. So even if we did our own things, it's always come back to Spintronix.
Cause they're in the place. It's a Luke Skywalker and a ghetto bass. If it's bass that you want on ghetto, you depend. When the smoke blows over, they'll be there in the end. With a high powered system and DJs galore, they control your body while vibrating the floor. Consider self warned cause they're on the case. A message from ghetto, feel the bass.
Let the bass go, let the bass go. Let the bass, let the bass go. Let the bass go, let the bass go.
Drop that
what?
Bass.
I bet. I don't wanna, cause if I do, you might lose it. I made this record for you to jam, so use it.